Today, I'm going to tell you 5 more things that surprised me in Poland. Boom! Cześć ludzie! What's up, people? Hola, VIGO'S dad here. It's just such a nice weather today. It's 28 degrees. It feels so nice. So I decided, let's come out and just enjoy the outdoors. But you know what? Before I start, let's change this lens. And we're back. This lens a little bit better, a little wider. So we're gonna do part 2 of the things that surprised me in Poland, because I must say that the first video has been extremely successful, guys. The amount of views, we are like almost 12,000 views. You know, it's not always easy to get your point across when you're talking about someone else's country and when you're trying to explain things that you find interesting. Come over with me, let's talk about 5 more things that surprised me in Poland. Let's go. Number 1, Polish TV. So we're in Poland. We decided it's movie night and, you know, turn on the TV.
Co jest na TVN-ie? Władca pierścieni. Ej, co to za głos? To jakiś dubbing? Co to ma być?
For you guys that don't know, in Poland they have this guy who's called the lektor. He's supposed to translate movies that come in other languages, read the dialogues that the characters are saying. So it doesn't matter what happens, this guy has the same tone of voice, and he's not even faux nor foul. He's not like he's overly excited, but he's also not overly sad. Polish lektor is there speaking, and most of the times, I don't even know he's there. Another thing that surprised me quite a lot on Polish TV was the amount of ads with medicine. You're watching the show and then you have reklama, commercials, and I'm not kidding you guys, 80% of the commercials are medicine. Medicine for your stomach, medicine for your hangover, and you guys are so used to it that obviously you don't even notice it. I remember that I told my wife and I said, hey, have you noticed how many commercials are there with medicine? And she was like, actually true. Have you ever just hugged a tree? They say it's great. Let's try. Number 2, weather.
Kuba, załóż kapcie. Kuba, zapnij się. Gdzie masz kurtkę?
If you're Polish, there's a very high chance that you've heard these phrases many times throughout your childhood. You might be even saying them to your kids. And that was very surprising to me, which is that Polish people are not that good with cold weather. All right, hold on, hold on. Don't click that dislike button just yet. Hear me out. I don't want to say that you overdress, but you do wear a lot of layers. You live in a country that has very harsh winters, and frostbite and pneumonia are real dangers out there. I've discovered that Polish people don't like feeling cold. You're great at covering up, using the right amount of winter gear, the right amount of layers, but the moment that your skin gets exposed, and I know what you're saying, you're probably thinking, what is this Latino here telling me how to deal with cold? I know, we are terrible. If it's below 10 degrees, we cannot even think straight. In my particular case, I like feeling cold. I hate feeling hot. This right now is getting a little bit too much. No, seriously, it's getting a little bit too much. Let's go to the shadow. Vigo would have gone crazy for that. Okay, how do I explain this one? Number 3, communism. There are traces of communism everywhere in Poland. And when you go for the first time or for the first times, it starts to become very apparent how much of it is ingrained in the society. It's in the architecture, it's even in the mindset of some of the citizens. Pani na kasie w PKS-ie, the lady selling tickets at the train station, she's gonna have a little bit of attitude. She's gonna tell you things straightforward like they are. She's gonna get pissed at you because you don't have change. But all games aside, I don't wanna mock this. This is a society that has gone through a lot of hardship. Communism was not a good time. You know, we are neighbors with Cuba, so we kinda have an idea what communism was about. And I'm thankful that Dominican Republic was never part of something like this. Other things that were actually quite interesting to me and astonishing were the famous bar mlechne, or the literal translation in English would be milk bars. This became quite popular after the First World War, but they actually became crucial after the Second World War, especially after Poland became a communist state where most people were living in poverty, contrary to official propaganda. And also the more upscale restaurants were labeled capitalist. Most people could not afford to eat in a decent place outside, so bar mlechne became a crucial and integral part of the Polish community and culture, where you could be served nourishing food for, you know, not so expensive. And I actually feel quite lucky and humbled that I was able to go to one and to enjoy some delicious Polish food that was served in the traditional way, that was served even during those hard times. Okej, okay, żart dla was. Przychodzi facet do okulisty i mówi: dzień dobry, poproszę okulary. Do czego? Do widzenia. Do widzenia. She's making fun of my dad joke. That's something else that surprised me quite a lot when I went to Poland. And actually, you know, all throughout my experience with Polish people, it's humor. The humor of Polish people is actually a little bit different. It's, first of all, it's darker. You guys have darker sense of humor, for sure. It's a little bit more self-deprecating.
Yeah, sarcastic, self-deprecating.
Yeah, sometimes she would make jokes. When she lived in the Dominican Republic for, you know, a year, and sometimes she would make jokes, and then people would be like,
feel bad for me.
Don't say that about yourself, like, she's just joking. But anyways, it's more, a little bit more self-deprecating. And also, it happens that, you know, we have a lot of Polish movies, and some of them are supposed to be comedies, and then they
supposed to be comedies.
And they have, you know, they have English subtitles, but, you know, sometimes I sit there and they are looking at me like, wasn't funny, and I'm like,
yeah, they have too many cultural references and like language jokes.
Yeah,
like you have to, and they are not translatable.
It's like more, I mean, you said it to
and
me
the context,
day, like, yeah,
okay,
like
and
context.
The cultural context is like, for example, we were trying to see Sami Swoi, and you are not getting it at all.
And another thing is that
you have to try maybe more modern ones.
Maybe, but I noticed.
But we've seen several stand-ups and they were kind of entertaining.
Dark humor again. And the last thing that I noticed about the Polish humor is that a lot of the times it's not followed by laughter per se. Like, for example, you guys don't make what you would call, you know, like stupid joke faces, kind of like a Jim Carrey type of things like Americans do. You guys are more like with substance, you know, the joke itself is inside the joke, it's not a funny face that you made, you know what I mean?
I've
noticed that.
Yeah, but I also thought that you meant that we don't, like, fall over laughing, like we sometimes just say,
yeah,
oh,
like,
that's
like,
funny,
like sometimes like jokes don't follow a laughter, you know what
yeah,
I mean? Like,
okay,
like you're not gonna go and say, yeah, da-da-da, you know what I mean? Okay, so that's it, that surprised me, your humor. The last thing that actually surprised me quite a lot when I went to Poland is the name situation. So let me explain.
We have 5 names only.
Exactly.
Ten
you
names.
Have a pool of names that is actually quite small. I met a lot of Magdas, a lot of Katarzyna, a lot of Ania, and
well, Karolina also is not that original. Every generation has their pool of names that repeat, and they're very, very common in my grandparents' generation, parents' generation, and my generation. And then the next generation is gonna have new, you know, recycled names that are not gonna be in fashion.
I get it. But yeah, that was quite surprising. And for example, when we knew that Vigo was gonna be a boy, I was very much in love with the name Vigo. I love the actor Viggo Mortensen, that's where I got it from. But the name, I fell in love with it, and I proposed it to her, and she was at the beginning like,
yeah, with the V, how we're gonna make diminutives, and, you know, declension, and all those things that I was thinking it's not gonna work in Polish.
Yeah.
But you said, what did you say?
I said, we can name him Vigus.
Oh, because and I was
Vigus.
Like, yeah, it's adorable.
But
how does it compare to Dominican Republic names?
Yeah, in Dominican Republic, basically, we have also like a pool of names that are repeated all the time,
classic,
but it's a lot, yeah,
names.
Classic.
Like the biblical names, they exist in all languages.
Yes.
But apart from that,
the main difference is that we use a lot of compound names, which I don't think you guys use them as much, like
we
you
don't.
Can have.
But we never
call
use
you by
a
your
second name.
Yeah, we do a lot. So that opens the possibility that you get one name that is classic, and a second name that is a little bit more risque, like
Batman.
Juan Batman Rodriguez.
So you combine two names to create a new name for your baby. Like
completely,
100%. Half a name from the father and half a name from the mother.
Yes, Juan and Carolina, and it can be Huacar. I'm not kidding either.
Yes, I've heard many of them that sound like this.
You know what? It gives me the idea. Would you like to see a video where we talk about the things that surprised her about Dominican Republic? What surprised
dirt.
Her the most?
I have some dirt.
Let us know. Vote thumbs up if you want to see that. boom, that's all, people. That's the end of the episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you very much. Thank you all you guys for all the comments, all the subscriptions. The way that this channel is growing is literally blowing my mind. Hopefully we'll bring you guys some more cool content soon. And thank you for subscribing. If you haven't, I hope this video earned me your subscription, and see you in the next video. Have a great time.